theme of our concert this evening. And doing the research for this concert, I came up with two new songs that I did not know about. The first we just heard, Jubilance. And in the composer's own words, it's a concert overture that reflects the many moods of life today, a restless, impatient, impulsive, and energetic existence. It is colorful and sonorous, with an insistent rhythmic drive. Then most ideas never get a chance to really complete themselves before they're interrupted. So I thought that was a really neat piece. Our next piece is also a concert overture called Jubilista by Claude T. Smith, who is one of the icons of the early band movement. It offers solo opportunities for the flute, trumpet, trombone, French horn, clarinet, and alto sax. Using contrasting tempo and meter changes, this work will be an ensemble favorite, and I hope an audience pleaser.
Do Quintet's going to be playing A Spirit Be Joyful, which is transcribed by Johann Sebastian Bach and transcribed by Henry Hertford. The seventh movement of J.S. Bach, entitled number 146, My Spirit Be Joyful, is originally scored by for tenor and bass soloists with two oboes, string, and continuo. The text is simple, and the melodicism is melismatic. The structure is ABA with a vivacious F major A section, which is followed idiomatically by a still energetic B section in minor, and then return to an A section for full restatement. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Okay, so the whole reason behind the theme for tonight's concert was that piece. So the student group, it consists of two juniors on trombone and euphonium, a freshman on, well, trumpet, but he's actually, well, Devin's Crystal is a violinist major, but he picked up trumpet last September and is playing at that high of a level already. And Silas is actually a cello major, but plays tuba and trombone. So let's give them all a round of the hand. And also thank you to Miss Sonia Crenshaw, our adjunct horn instructor, for filling in as well. The next piece is entitled Joyful. It's arranged by Michael Treni. I think is how you say that. And it's based on Beethoven's Ode to Joy from his Ninth Symphony. And this arrangement is based on jazz rhythms and idioms and chord voicings. So we hope you enjoy this version of Joyful. here to announce the next piece is student conductor, senior music major, Willie Godfrey.
Hello. It's very weird being in front of everybody. I'm normally in the back, so it's a little weird being up in front of everybody. But my name's Willie G. Godfrey, and today we're going to be doing Yesu, Joy of, oh gosh, I forgot the name, Joy of Man's Desiring. J.S. Bach composed it, and he was really active in the late Baroque period, and this is actually written as a cantata, or the end of a cantata. And Alfred Reed did the joy of, see what did their joy, of arranging it for wind ensemble. So, hope you guys enjoy.
Thank you.
So if you haven't been to a jazz band concert, you've not heard Will on the piano. He's a wonderful pianist and percussionist and just all around really, really fine musician. And we're gonna be sad to see him graduate in May, but we're hoping that the job goes through. He's close to getting one. We hope it works down where he's been working as a percussion instructor for a couple of years. So let's keep our fingers, thoughts, and him in our prayers for that. Now for our next piece. Composed in 1995, Joy is the final movement of Joseph Corelli's Awakening, which are about songs of the earth, originally written for orchestra. He arranged this movement himself for the wind ensemble. And he describes it as rambunctious and exciting, evocative of open spaces with a Copland and Bernstein cowboy Perry feel. So, Joy.
Thank you. get a kick out of the percussion running around back there, back and forth, back and forth. That mallet part is really, really hard. Let's give another round of a hand to Sam and Mr. Hill. When Friends Rejoice, by young composer Carl Holmquist, expresses the spirit of friends coming together to make music, simply for the love of music. The opening solo, played on the bass clarinet by sophomore music education major Katie Varn, is based on the hymn, How Can I Keep From Singing, but the melody is inversed, so if you know the tune, you'll notice that it's backwards and upside down. The music undergoes twists and turns, expressing joyful sounds, dance-like movements, and heartfelt melodies. And this one is a lot of fun to be in front of. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
isn't that piece really fun?
Mm-hmm.
It's beautiful. Yeah, so thank you for attending tonight's concert and supporting our students and our community members that we just love playing music. So that's what we do. We really love doing this. And don't forget to come out on Sunday afternoon at 4 o'clock for the University Singers Choir Concert. And Monday evening, 7 o'clock for the Chamber Strings Concerts. So our last piece on the program, it's time to do a little bit of Christmas music. John Rutter Christmas, the second one, features holiday feature favorites such as Ding Dong Merrily on High, The Very Best Time of Year, I Saw Three Ships, Song's Day Carol, Angel's Carol, and finally, We Wish You a Merry Christmas. And we do wish you a Merry Christmas.